One of the greatest struggles in conservation biology is that there are limited funds. This can mean that some difficult decisions have to be made about how money is allocated and what species are protected. The key is figuring out how best to spend this money, which often involves identifying a species like a keystone, flagship, or umbrella species to direct funds at. In this video, I hope to explain the concept of the umbrella species, how it fits in with keystone, indicator, and flagship species, as well as some criticisms of the concept. So, umbrella species are species that can be defined as a single species that generally requires a large area to be protected to ensure its conservation, and because of that, their conservation will also ensure the conservation of the other species in the ecosystem. For example, saving a species like the African elephant, which requires large protected preserves for its persistence into the future, also ensures habitat for all the antelope, termites, snakes, butterflies, and small mammals that call its habitat, the African savanna, home. They are basically giving conservationists the most bang for their buck and protect entire ecosystems under the umbrella of protecting a single species. The idea of umbrella species often overlaps with the idea of flagship, indicator, or keystone species. Keystone species are species that have an important role in maintaining ecosystems, and the loss of these species has cascading effects leading to the ecosystem structure completely changing. Flagship species are species that are so iconic that they basically are ambassadors for endangered animals that can be used to sell conservation to the general public. Think the giant panda in the World Wildlife Fund, or how often you see tigers, sea turtles, or elephants in the context of conservation organizations. Indicator species are species whose presence or absence gives a qualitative indication of how an ecosystem is doing. If it is present, then the habitat is healthy. If it is absent, the ecosystem is not healthy. Often, large, charismatic flagship animals make great umbrella species. For example, the Amur tiger needs huge areas of unbroken wilderness, and, as an apex predator, it also requires healthy populations of herbivores, so its presence indicates a healthy ecosystem. Whales require vast tracts of ocean and vast amounts of food, which in turn protect other organisms that share the same habitat and food. However, umbrella species do not have to necessarily be large or well-known. In the Pacific Northwest, spotted owls require areas of undisturbed old-growth forests, which in turn protect salamanders and terrestrial mollusks. Even more unlikely, umbrella species can be insects. Like keeping vehicles out of conservation areas for the coral pink sand dune tiger beetle keeps the dune vegetation, including some endemic species, intact. While it may seem simple to identify an umbrella species, it is not always easy to do so, and there is no guarantee that protecting an umbrella species will also protect other organisms in its ecosystem. This is where having a species that also acts as an indicator or keystone species, as well as an umbrella species, can be really helpful in making sure other species are also being protected. A research team in Japan looked at how effective the northern goshawk, a species that was being referred to as an umbrella species by conservationists, actually was at being an umbrella species. What they found was these birds of prey not only inhabited the forest that they were interested in protecting, but also farmland, which meant that its presence could not indicate the health of other species in the ecosystem, which suggests that protecting it may not be able to actually protect other species. However, in Italy, northern goshawks seem to not have the same preference for agricultural land, staying in mature forest interiors, so if they are doing well, it can be inferred that other organisms are doing well. These two studies show that the concept is not all that straightforward, and a species that may be an umbrella species in one part of the world is not one in another. Ecosystems are incredibly complex, and a common criticism of keystone, umbrella, and indicator species is that it is just too simplistic. These two goshawk studies seem to suggest that we almost have to evaluate each umbrella species on how effective it is at protecting its ecosystem on almost a case-by-case basis. And not just saying it worked over here in this specific habitat, it will work over in this completely different habitat. Another issue is that preserves set up to protect a given umbrella species may not be necessarily optimal for protection of all other species that share the preserve. In the study that found the spotted owl worked as an umbrella species, the researchers also found that the existing preserves to protect spotted owls specifically did not necessarily overlap with the areas of highest salamander or mollusk diversity. This shows that other factors need to be considered when constructing preserves for an umbrella species that also take into account where hotspots of other taxa are and working these into reserve networks. A study looking at the effectiveness of a rare butterfly in the San Francisco region as an umbrella species found that if the butterfly was protected at all sites it currently exists, it would work well to protect native plants. However, if only the sites with the largest populations were protected, then the effectiveness of using the butterfly as an umbrella species drops. Again, suggesting that a case-by-case approach is the only way for this concept to work. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. What do you think of the concept of umbrella species? Do you think we need a case-by-case understanding if a species works as an umbrella species? This video is part of a Fundamentals of Conservation Biology series with a new episode coming out once a month. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and ring the bell so you will be reminded when the next episode in this series comes out.